Don Dada. Fire can't cool me, I burn tire.
Original bad man.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new to the channel, my name is Miriam Maulana. Welcome to my little world on the internet. If you're an oldie but a goodie, you know I love you, I appreciate you. Thank you so much for joining me as always. In today's video, I am going to be showing you guys how I achieve this updo with the cornrowed front and the beads, because I'm all about beads. For winter, okay, I want to rock trendy, fun hairstyles, no to boring. Nope, I refuse. So anyways, this is such a simple hairstyle. Most of the hairstyles that I'm going to be sharing are things for busy people that you can achieve in under an hour should you have the time. So I really do hope that you enjoy the video. Don't forget to comment down below letting me know what hairstyle you'd like to see next, or what video you'd like to see next, and I will be happy to bring you that content. I'm chasing the sun, so I've got to go. I love you so much. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
Hairstyles are very easy. We're going to start off by parting the hair from one ear to the other as per usual, because it's a half up half. Well, it's going to be half and half. Half hair at the back and then half cornrow in the front. My hair was so painful to part, you guys. That's why they're the looks. And then that's why I was just like, you know what? Screw straight lines. This is painful. I'm going to leave it. And then when you're done doing that, I don't know why I used the comb, but just section your hair at the back. To get it out the way, because you are going to be cornrowing your hair, and the one thing you don't want is to be pulling any hair from the back. You want to keep that slightly crooked line as straight as you possibly can. So I'm now going to section the front, and I'm going to section that in kind of a V shape, because I want that to be the thicker of all my cornrowing styles. I am going to do kind of like stitch braiding in the front. The one thing that I do want to tell you is, with the stitch braiding, the way that I am going to be parting it is, I am going to be doing a braid out, like maybe 1-2 braids before each section. However, if you have rubber bands at home, then you can use rubber bands. The reason why I am showing you guys this way of doing it is because some people don't like using rubber bands in their hair. They say that rubber bands snag on their hair. So this is a different way to do stitch braiding without using rubber bands. I just pressed my aloe vera water concoction in my hair. It's just simple aloe vera from the leaf itself and a little bit of water, and then I just keep it in the fridge and I spritz that on my hair for moisture every single day, or especially when I am protective styling. So this is what I was saying. All you need to do is section your hair. Make sure not to pull into any ends. You don't want to rip your hair from the roots. And then what you're going to do at this point is you're going to braid just a little bit, as you can see, 1, 2, 3 times. Oh, that's not 3 times, but you're just going to braid a little bit and section them. And the reason why I want that is because I want those like cross horizontal lines. Like, I really want that look with the stitch braiding, because I am going to cornrow all that to the back, and it makes it look different. And I mean, different is good. And now what you're going to do is you're going to cornrow that part of your hair. You're also going to be using braids. You will be adding braids just to get a little bit of thickness, but hey, if you aren't keen for thickness, then don't worry about it. Just braid it all the way down using your old hair. However, the using a braid kind of helps it look uniform. My hands were so painful braiding. The middle of your head is painful, okay? My thick ass arms were just like, oh babe, we have not exercised in so long, and now you're going to decide that you're going to be doing these type of hairstyles. So just braid till the section part of your hair. Be strong, it's not that bad. The pain subsides as soon as you put your hands down. And then I'm going to section a part of my sides on both sides of my head. So a lot of the styles are going to be repetitive, because it's going to look the same on either side of my head. And then I am going to cornrow from the back coming forward, because I want those like forward look crossing cornrows in the front where I'm going to be adding my beads. Again, spritz your hair with olive oil, with your aloe vera, or just simple water if you have water at home. It's just to add moisture as your protective styling. Moisture is important for growth and for healthy hair. So I'm just going to spritz a little bit of my water, and then I'm going to go in with a little bit of my oil mix, and then I am going to seal all of that with, I am going to go in with my water, then I'm going to follow that with my Dark and Lovely moisturizing butter, and then I'm going to seal all of that with my oil mix. You can use olive oil, coconut oil, you can use black castor oil. Black castor oil is perfect for sealing in moisture. The other oils might be too light to seal in moisture, but it works for me. Just make sure that as you're braiding, you're not pulling or snagging on your hairline. Again, protect your hairline, protect your hair, and carry it on. So as you can see, I did that on both sides. I conrolled from the back all the way to the front. Those were just two lines because those were the two lines that I wanted to do and add the beads on later. And now you're just going to section your hair into almost like an L shape, but it's more of a, I don't know what that is, it's a curve, guys, a curve. But you can also just section it into an L shape, and you're going to conroll that, adding a little bit of braids, just like a half a braid. The reason why I'm saying you should do that is, again, I want my conrolls to be a tad thicker than they would be if I just use my hair alone. You don't need to do this, it's just a preference thing. I'm going to do the exact same style of conroll on my left side. And continue to do that up until I've braided both sections that are left over. So again, you're going to do an L curve line, and then the hair that's left over, you just conroll it all the way to the back. You can style this any way you want. You can do zigzags just to make the hair style a little bit more fun and funky and, you know, edgy and futuristic if you'd like. Okay, so go with whatever you like. If you wanted to do bunch knots down this line, do it. It's just to add a little bit of, you know, vagavoom to my hairstyle. And then for the back of my head, all I am going to do is I'm going to go in again with my aloe vera and water mixture to moisturize the back of my hair. Add my oil and then also add my butter to keep that moisture before going in with my eco styler gel. The eco styler gel that I'm currently testing is the Crystal 10 Max Hold. The reason why I haven't really given you guys a review of this is because I'm not there yet. I'm not at the position where I can tell you guys whether I love it or I hate it, but so far it's working well. It keeps my hair held up, and my hair is very kinky, as you can see in the beginning there. So all you're going to do is you're going to apply as much eco styler gel as you need. You're going to go in with a brush, and then you're just going to brush it all the way up and make it mix. Let it meet your conrolls in the center of your hair. You're going to now lay your edges again using eco styler gel. As you saw before I applied my eco styler gel, I went in with my water just for moisture. And this is about full face beat later, and my hair is all sleeked down all at the back, and also as you can see my edges are laid for the god, you guys. I'm now going to go in with my kinky hair. The one that I'm using is called Sublime. I just got it from a Nigerian shop, like my closest beauty supply store. So you can go online and buy it at Hair City. Just look for hair, kinky textured hair. Sometimes if you just maybe go into shop and ask them hair that looks like Molly hair, it's really kinky, it's textured, it's the closest thing that I've seen to 4C hair. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to wrap it around itself in the at the start. The reason why I do that is I wanted it to be longer so that when I'm wrapping it around itself it's long. So I didn't put my scrunchie in the middle, in the center where I normally do. I put it further at the ends, like 3/4 way, so that there's just a little bit left over. And now I'm just going to go and section those, put them on two different sides, and then I am going to twist that hair. After twisting it, I'm just going to fluff it a little bit to get more volume, because I really want this bun to be big, and I want it to have so much volume. And if I just twisted it, then it would just be a normal bun. But I want it big, I want it out there. So that's why I go ahead and fluff it. If you want it to be more tapered, or if you want it to be smaller, you use less hair, and you also don't fluff it in the end like I just did. I used about a packet of hair. I don't know how many strands that was, but it's the whole packet that I just split into two halves. And then you're going to go around, play around with it, wrap it around itself until you get the perfect bun. Make sure it's in the center of your head, because you don't want your head to end up looking squonky. Okay, so that's just me playing around with it, making sure that it's going to be right in the center where I want it. After you are done doing that, again, go ahead and thread the front. Remember the cornrows that we did from the back all the way to the front? You're going to thread those, and kids, get the right type of beads. This whole thing of using beads from your necklace is painful because I'm tired of eating hair. Like, it's not as fun as I make it look hair. If you get the right type of beads, though, you can also buy a beader, which will make it so much simpler to add beads to your hairstyles. Now just go in with your hair jewelry. I go for gold because that's kind of what works with my olive yellow undertone. If you want silver, go for silver. Just go for what you like and what you love and what suits you. I just place them randomly all around my head, and there you go. Now I've got my beads and my gold jewelry. I mean, a bad man them want to
So I've kind of been testing out the eco styler gel that you guys saw in the tutorial today, and sometimes it seems to flick and sometimes it doesn't. So I'm going to keep trying it out, and then I'll come back to you guys and let you know. I'm trying out in different stages just to see if it works better when your hair is dry or when your hair is wet, and does it flick after you reapply, all those small little details. So I'm going to come back to you guys with an eco styler gel review. Reason being, eco styler gel is not available here in South Africa. You can purchase eco styler gel from Clicks. I know you guys are always asking me. You can now purchase it from any Clicks stores in South Africa. So that's the reason why I can now finally do different reviews for eco styler gel. Anyways guys, like I said, this is such a simple hairstyle. You can achieve it in under an hour. If you do want to come at me and ask me any questions, feel free to hit me down below in the comment section if you want me to film any other videos. It can even be makeup, guys. Just challenge me, let me know what you want to know from, what you want to see from me, and I would love to come back to you guys with information that you're going to enjoy. Anyways, I love you so much. I am chasing the sun, so I've got to go. As you can see, that's why my skin is looking extra gold and melanin. My and my highlights is popping. So I love you so much. Bye, honeys. Mwah, mwah, mwah.